it's definitely not that. Okay. Is it the right or the left hand? It's the left hand. Left hand, left hand.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have... I'm telling you now, it was Mukura...
You're wrong.
Even there's another part of the...
Oh? Is it the right or the left hand?
No, no, no.
Maybe the right foot. Or perhaps the left foot.
I messed it up.
Or could it be...
No, it's
the
not.
The hips.
No.
Okay. You never saw their face, right?
Get rid of that.
So you can't have any idea who was under that mask.
I don't want left
I'm
hand.
I'm telling you now, it was Mukuro Ikus.
You're wrong. Even without seeing their face,
there's another part of the...
Oh? Is it the right or the left hand?
I think that's gonna work. Yeah. Because I need the regular thing. I need the file. Yeah.
Shoot!
That's... I know, because you wouldn't let me go back there.
You
That's
never saw their face, so you can't have... I'm telling you now!
Yeah.
You're wrong.
Yeah.
There's another part of the...
Oh? Is it the right hand?
No.
Or the left hand? Maybe the right foot!
Isn't it? Because they're standing over you. Oh, it is the right. The right hand is the one with the knife. The left hand is the one they're pointing toward you. So it would be the left hand, though. Okay, they're going with something else, then.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have any idea who was under that mask! I'm telling you now, it was
You're wrong. There's another part of the-
Oh? Is it the right- Or the left hand? Maybe the right foot! Or perhaps the left foot! Or could it be... the hips?
Maybe it's the right hand. Let me try the right hand.
You never saw there, so you can't have... I'm telling
up.
You now, it...
You're wrong. There's another part of the...
Oh? Is it the right or the left hand?
Yeah, it's not that. And I screwed up.
Shoot!
Yep, I failed. What else is new? Yep.
Is...
No.
I refuse to give up yet!
Okie dokie. Good. Okay, then it has to do with taking it and placing it. And not using the file. That's what it has to do with then.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have any idea who- I'm telling you now, it was Mukuro Ikusaba!
You're wrong. Even without seeing their face, there's another part of the attacker we can use to prove it.
Oh?
I know what I need to do.
Is it the right or the left hand? Maybe the right foot! Or perhaps-
It's either like this, or it's the other way.
The hips!
Yeah.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have it! I'm telling you now! It was Mukuro
No, that's wrong!
Mukuro
had a tattoo on her right hand, if I a representation of Fenrir. In other words, a wolf tattoo.
Oh, she did have... Okay.
But I saw the right hand of the person who attacked me. And there was no such tattoo. So there's no way the person behind the mask was Mukuro.
Yeah, well, okay. You got me. I guess it wasn't her. But that still doesn't prove that it was me. It could have been, you know, someone else, right?
Hiro, Toko, Hina, and I all have solid alibis for that entire night.
Yeah! We were in the gym tearing you apart, so it couldn't have been any of us.
Oh, okay, sure. It couldn't have been any of you, but what about Kyoko? It totally could have been her. Uh-oh! No snappy comeback. Did I score a bullseye?
If you insist, I don't mind showing you.
Huh? Show me what?
What do you think? I'll show you the one thing that proves beyond a shadow of a doubt it wasn't me.
Okay. Pull off her glove.
Yeah. Your hands!
Awful, isn't it? It happened when I was first learning to be a detective. I was inexperienced.
I thought you didn't want anyone to see those scars.
If it means we get another step closer to unmasking the mastermind, it doesn't really bother me.
Okay.
My scars should suffice as proof.
Yeah. That's
Makoto, that. Did the person who attacked you have scars like mine?
Nope.
No, not at all. I'm positive.
Then this much has been made clear. There can be no doubt that the one who attacked Makoto is the true mastermind.
Yep.
This is just awful! On top of my secret being revealed, I had to look at those positively grotesque scars of yours! Sorry, did I say that out loud? I do hope I didn't hurt your feelings.
Not at all. You can say whatever you want.
Yeah.
Sure. As long as it means pushing me farther into the corner, right? But I'm not cornered just yet.
No,
because
not yet.
If you haven't noticed, the circumstances surrounding Mukuro's death are totally unknown.
Nope, not true.
That's true.
It's not true.
All we know right now is she was killed a good while before this morning.
On the contrary, we don't know anything other than that.
You're not going to tell us she was already dead before we arrived here or something, are you?
In that regard, you have nothing to worry about. I promise you, without a doubt, she died after our little killing game began here.
Then somehow, she was killed in secret without any of us knowing.
That's what you think.
And after she died, who knows how much time went by before we found her, right? Did the culprit stash her somewhere? She couldn't have been in the garden the whole time, could she?
If she was, she would have been totally decomposed. Just like your brain!
Then, she was being stored somewhere?
But...
hide a body.
To hide a body here? To just store it somewhere?
Well, storing a body would be the biolab.
I got it! Mukuro's body was probably kept hidden in the biolab.
Biolab? You mean on the fifth floor?
Yep. We found you fainted.
That's right. It's actually set up for use as a morgue, so it's the perfect place to hide a body. And it'd keep the body preserved at the same time.
Then you're also saying the body was moved from the biolab to the garden.
And I have no doubt that that's exactly what happened.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I have proof.
The tarp. Yep. Is the tarp. No. What? Where's my tarp? Biolab secret. No. What happened to my tarp? Where'd my tarp go? Oh. How did I miss that?
I got it!
How?
What makes me so sure the body was carried from the biolab to the garden is...
the tarp that was used.
The tarp that we found in the garden.
Mm-hmm.
When I was checking it over again, I noticed something.
It said
I noticed
biolab.
That some text had been stamped on one corner of the tarp.
Oh, it says biolab.
Yep.
Holy cow! How'd you notice that tiny little thing?
Makoto's nitpicky nature seems to have surfaced with perfect timing.
This proves that the tarp originally came from the biolab.
Yep.
In fact, there's a whole stack of tarps just like it in there.
Mm-hmm.
So when the killer moved the body to the garden, they must have grabbed a tarp to wrap it in.
Mm-hmm.
Then they simply left it as it was to protect against the sprinklers. And put the...
Wow, you made everything sound so amazingly consistent.
That's just a wild guess! Where's your evidence? Prove that the body was wrapped in a tarp and moved!
There is no evidence. I was simply explaining what I think happened. But you seem to be getting pretty worked up about it, wouldn't you say?
Worked up?
Mm-hmm.
Now that the conversation has turned to the topic of the biolab, you must be getting pretty nervous. Because the key to uncovering your secret identity is hidden within that room, isn't it?
Are you talking about unmasking the mastermind?
Yep.
You see, the biolab contained an inconsistency. One so major it can't be overlooked.
La la la! I can't hear you! La 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 la!
Such a child. Oh well, just ignore him.
Hey, by the way, Makoto, what about that one thing?
What?
Shut up.
One thing.
Don't listen to him.
What do you think I'm talking about? Your family.
Oh, he's really going for me now. The video.
Don't tell me you forgot about that video message.
Yep.
So what do you think? Are you sure your family's still okay?
Why are you bringing that up now?
Your mom, your dad, your little sister. What do you think has happened to your family? Are they really as safe as you might have assumed?
Stop talking about that!
Calm down, Makoto. He wants you to get upset.
Nope, he's baiting you. Baiting you. Yep. Focus. Yep. Truth about the biolab. Numbers just don't match up. Moment of truth. Oh, hell no, not this.
Are you sure about this? Are you sure about this? That's impossible!
Go, 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 go,
what?
Go.
What do you want? Are you sure about this? That's impossible!
Why can't I do anything about
that? Are you sure about this? That's impossible!
What?
Are you sure about this?
That's
impossible!
Bringing anything on.
Are you sure about this? That's impossible!
I think this is a can't win situation.
What? What do you want?
Because I can't target it. I can't do anything. That had to have... How it's supposed to happen, right? No? Are you kidding me? What?
Is
Are you kidding me?
I refuse to give up yet!
Oh... Crap, so it's gonna be a freaking gameplay mechanic that's gonna screw me. So why were the first ones working, the other ones weren't? I'm forgetting about some other thing, aren't I?
Are you sure about this? That's impossible! Are you sure about this? That's impossible! What? What do you want? Are you sure about this? That's impossible! Are you sure about this?
There's some
That's
button to switch.
Are you sure about this? That's impossible!
Okay, final strike.
I'm not listening!
Oh damn it, hit the wrong one. Lights, yeah, the lights. I missed it.
Are you sure about this? That's impossible!
Okay, come on.
I'm not listening!
The lights, the lights, the lights, the lights.
This should prove it.
Yep. It's the lights.
The inconsistency Kyoko's talking about is...
The lights.
The lights!
Yep.
What are you talking about? What about the lights?
Well, like I said before, the biolab also acts as a morgue.
Mm-hmm.
And as part of that, a giant refrigerator was installed in there. That's where everyone who's died is stored.
And it was set up so that when a slot had a body in it, a blue light would turn on.
In other words, if the blue light is on, that means there's a body in that slot.
Exactly.
But I counted up the number of blue lights that were on, including the one Mukuro was in, and there were only nine.
Yep.
Why does that matter? You gotta give me the bite-sized version here, man.
Nine lights doesn't make sense. The number of lights should be... I believe it's 10.
I got it!
Yeah.
10 of the lights should have been on.
Any other number
is incredibly suspicious.
Because 10 of us are dead. Or so we think.
Suspicious? Why?
That's simple. Just recall who's died here so far, and it should become clear.
Yep. Junko. Leon. Junko. Mondo. Taka. Celeste. Wait, I thought Junko was first.
So 10 people in all?
I remember that wrong.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Any other number should make you immediately suspicious. But according to the lights in the biolab,
only nine
people were being stored there.
You're seeing a dead body just up and disappeared?
I got it! The mastermind destroyed one of the bodies to get rid of evidence.
But if they wanted to do that, they would have destroyed Mukuro's body, since they actually killed her.
Exactly.
And yet, her body was left alone.
Then, whose body disappeared?
It may very well be that none of them disappear.
But if that's true, then why doesn't the body count match?
Including Monokuma's executions, there have apparently been 10 deaths. But there were only nine bodies. That's the point I'm trying to make.
I'm completely lost. How can the number of victims be less than the number of murders?
Explanation. Why is that? The same person was killed twice. Only nine murders took place. Dang it,
shoot!
Well, there are 10 bodies, but there's only been... Okay, fine. Same person was killed twice. Oh, yeah.
I got it!
Stupid.
What about if...
Exactly.
The same person was killed twice?
Huh? Killed twice?
Mm-hmm.
Officially... 10 murders have been committed so far, but one of the victims may have been murdered, and then murdered again.
Murdered and... murdered again?
Yep.
If that's the case, there could have been 10 killings, but still only 9 victims, right?
Technically you're right, I guess. But still... something like that...
could easily have happened. No. It is what happened.
Yep.
Sounds like you're already convinced. Then can you tell us who was killed twice?
Mm-hmm.
It was Mukuro, of course.
Yep.
Before she was killed as Mukuro Ikusaba, she was killed as someone else.
And that's why the body had to be stored in the biolab until the moment we found it in the garden.
No, that's crazy talk! She was killed as someone else? Come on! Besides, who could that someone else even have been?
All you have to do is look at those bodily injuries of hers, and that
Junko.
Will become obvious.
Junko...
Nothing's gonna become obvious!
No,
because Kyoko's totally delusional!
Sure. Okay, what's it gonna be? Crap, I have to grab something. That's what that means. What do we got?
Who is this someone else that Mukuro was killed as? Mm-hmm. Was it Sayaka Maizono?
Nope.
Junko Enoshima?
Yes.
Leon Kuwata?
Yep.
Chihiro Fujimando? Kiyotaki Fumi? Celestia? Or maybe... No, no, no. There's no way anyone was murdered twice!
Oh, yeah.
No, that's wrong!
Junko.
Junko.
Yep.
Wasn't her fatal injury pretty similar to Mukuro's?
What do you mean?
Let me explain. All the spears, remember?
Well, remember what happened to her? She was impaled by a bunch of spears. All over her body.
Yep.
And Mukuro died from a number of wounds across her body.
Yep.
When you compare that to the stab wounds Junko suffered...
Then the similarities match?
Mm-hmm. Yes, and those are the only fatal injuries that match up. That explains why those two bodies are actually one and the same.
So let me see if I have this straight. Junko, or someone going by that name, was stabbed to death with multiple spears.
Yes.
Then her body was kept in the bio lab for however long before being dragged out again.
Correct.
Only this time, it was presented as the corpse of one Mukuro Ikusaba.
Yep.
It all matches up, right? Those wounds Junko suffered could easily be these same injuries.
Then, it's really true? Mukuro and Junko are the same person? Wait, so then... What does it all mean?
It means that there haven't been 10 victims,
but 9.
Which also means that among the people we thought were dead, one is still alive.
And that's the true identity of the mastermind?
Yep.
Who is it? Who's behind all this?
We already know the answer to that. It's Mukuro. She's still alive. She took Junko's body and made it look like she was the one who died. So Mukuro is still alive. She's gotta be. Total silence? Then I must be right. I'm right, aren't I?
One that still lives in Mukuro, but can we really believe that? Yeah. Probably your profile.
The body we found in the garden.
Because it matches.
It wasn't Mukuro.
It had to be.
No, that's wrong.
Because the profile.
No, the body we found in the garden was Mukuro. That's one thing we can be sure of. The body's appearance and
measurements
are consistent with her records.
Then Junko isn't dead.
Right, Kyoko?
She was 5'6" tall and weighed 97 pounds. Her vitals were 31, 21, 32. Everything in her profile is consistent with that corpse.
Yep.
And then there's the matter of the Fenrir tattoo. So there's no question it's her.
But if Mukuro's not the mastermind, then who's actually still alive?
Yeah, that was all a stunt, Junko. That's why she went and attacked Monokuma, and then she, quote, died. Yep.
Here's my answer!
It's Junko.
Junko is still alive. It's the only possibility.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, I am.
Huh?
I admit, since Mukuro is undoubtedly dead, Junko does seem to be the only other explanation. But we saw her get impaled. She died right before our very eyes.
That's what we think.
If Junko were still alive, the death we saw would had to have been some kind of charade.
Exactly.
But you yourself confirmed she was dead, did you not?
Gently placed my hand on Junko's lifeless body and touched her wrist to check for her pulse. Yeah, but there's all kinds of things that can get rid of your pulse and whatnot.
She was dead. There's no question. Junko was dead.
So, the idea that she's still alive...
It must be wrong.
Then you're withdrawing your previous statement?
Now I have a choice.
I know you gave it your best shot, but too bad. I guess your conclusion was a dud. Too bad, too bad.
This case hasn't been decided just yet.
Mm-hmm.
Oh?
Yeah.
You haven't given up already, have you, Makoto?
Hell no.
No, of course not. There's no way I'd give up that easy.
That's all well and good, but how do you intend to solve the problem standing in your way?
Well.
Junko absolutely died. Mukuro absolutely died.
Then both of them are dead, right? There can't be any kind of survivor story.
I think we need to look at this from the opposite direction.
Okay.
Huh? The opposite direction?
Mukuro's still alive?
Let's assume Junko is still alive. If so, how could she have survived?
I checked. She was dead, I'm sure of it. Okay. Still, if she were alive somehow... Someone else entirely... Someone else entirely? Okay, what's the word? R. Oh. Oh, okay, okay. Uh-huh.
Now I understand! That's it! What if she switched places with someone else?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, someone that looked like her, maybe?
Switched places?
That's right! Before the spears could kill her, she got someone to take her place!
That's right, because we were... okay, okay.
Specifically, Mukuro Usaba.
Ah. Okay, okay.
Then that would make it Mukuro's corpse that showed up later.
Which is why the body's height and weight match Mukuro's profile, right?
Okay.
I don't know anything about this switching places thing, but... That had to be Junko who got stabbed to death, right?
No.
Yeah, you're saying they switched? When could they even have done that?
Anytime before we... Because it was the first night. Anytime.
Right when she was about to die? Like she used some kind of ninja replacement technique?
No.
Good point.
Like that.
There's just no way they could have switched like that. So maybe the whole idea is wrong.
Not so fast.
I got it!
Yeah.
The two of them may have switched places from the very beginning.
Yeah.
What? From the beginning?
Exactly.
Yes, from the moment we first met. If that's when they switched.
We just assume that that's Joko.
Then they wouldn't have had to switch at the moment of death, right? After all, the one we saw at that point would have already been Mukuro.
Yeah.
But hold on! So, you're saying the Junko we first met...
wasn't Junko.
Was actually Mukuro all along?
Yep.
Then, we'd already met her?
Yep.
I had, like, a normal conversation with her.
When we first met, none of us knew who anyone else was. So Mukuro could have simply told us her name was Junko.
Yep. And we just assumed.
And we never would have known the difference.
Exactly.
That would easily allow the two of them to switch places from the very beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Wait! But Mukuro had a tattoo on the back of her hand, right?
Mm-hmm.
Junko never had any tattoo like that, did she?
She could have hidden it with foundation or something like that.
Yep.
If she did, it likely melted away in the explosion, exposing the tattoo after the body was extinguished.
And that's why the fingernails have the red. Okay.
Plus, there were the fake nails found on the hands of Mukuro's body.
Exactly.
They were the same fake red nails she was wearing when we all met for the first time.
Yep.
But if she really did use foundation...
Correct. Even if there was no tattoo on her hand, I couldn't say for certain it wasn't Mukuro. So I'm glad nobody noticed that glaring hole when we were trying to figure out who attacked Makoto.
Hmm.
But too bad for you, Monokuma. You can't deny it anymore.
Yeah.
Wait, so... this whole thing was a setup from the very beginning?
Mm-hmm.
If that's true, it was quite an elaborate plan to be sure, making it look like Mukuro was Junko.
The reason such an elaborate plan was possible is because the two of them were working together.
So Mukuro, the ultimate despair,
teamed up with someone like her. Yeah.
In other words, it would be fair to say that Junko herself was also the ultimate despair.
What's wrong? Lost the will to fight back?
I think he's just afraid.
Afraid? What's that mean, afraid? Fear is only possible where hope is possible. I only have despair, so fear is an alien concept to me.
Then why haven't you been saying anything?
Because it's a bunch of nonsense. Junko's my secret identity. As if.
Then why did you try and protect Junko's real identity?
I tried to protect her identity? When did I do that?
She died, and not just once, but twice. First time was during her last investigation. Monokuma file. No, that's not it.
Shoot!
Damn it. Okay, thanks, stupid. Tried to hide Junko's identity, and not just once, but twice. The first time was during our latest investigation. Profile. No.
Shoot!
So well. I feel like an idiot. The ultimate despair? The secret. The lights. Damn it.
Shoot!
Okay. One more time. Oh, I know three things it's not. Secret? Nope. Okay. What are that up to? I don't know. Damn it.
I refuse to give up yet!
So close. Come on.
The two of them
may have switched places from the very beginning. Oh crap, I gotta do all this slow again.
Yeah.
Nope. Mm-mm. Nope. Go. Go. Come on. Yep, go. Go on. Keep going. Okay, so I know what it's not. Okay. It's not the Monokuma file. Oh, the control room, maybe? Maybe the control room. Nope. Oh, crap. I don't see what they're putting down. The first time was during our latest investigation. It's not the file. It's not the control room. It's not the profile. Ultimate despair, maybe? It's not the lights or secret. The group photo. Right, Ed. Has to do with what Monokuma tried to keep me from seeing during the investigation. Okay, it's not that either then. Tarp, you mean? Injuries. Nope.
Shoot!
Because that. It's not that. Probably not that. I'm gonna go ultimate despair. That's not it either.
Shoot!
Seriously? Everything else is like making some kind of logical sense, and now it's like a huge leap. I did do the lights, right? Nope. I already did that. Okay. Awesome. Puto.
I refuse to give up.
And I gotta go through all that all over again to get all the way back there. I hate that. Come on, why can't you just have a checkpoint right there? Especially when you make it that damn difficult. Everything else makes sense. Putting everything together, but I don't know what you're going for. I really don't. Unless it's the tarp.
And
but even then, that doesn't sound. The tarp? I'll try the tarp, I guess. It's gotta be one of these things. Okay. I'm gonna start with the tarp. Nope. Maybe not the tarp. It's not the file. It's not the control room, not the tarp, not the profile, not the spare. I doubt it. That stuff doesn't have anything to do with it. No. It's not the secret, and it's not the lights. Confirm the secret again, please. Okay, not secret, not lights. 100% confirmed, it's not at those. Photo, doesn't make sense. Hidden room present, doesn't make sense. Group photo, tried it. Interview DVD, doesn't make sense. Fatal injury, wouldn't matter. Right? Yeah.
Shoot!
Okay. It's not the file. Places to check. It seems related. List?
Nope. Shoot!
It's not the file. It's not the list. It's not the control room. It's not the tarp. It's not the profile. It's not the spare. I doubt it's the present. I doubt it's the photo. I doubt it's a handbook. A locker. Locker. Group photo. Nope.
Shoot!
Oh my gosh. Everything else seemed to have like a logical leap, but now
I refuse
it just
to give
doesn't.
Up yet.
I just don't understand what they want. How did he try to cover it up? How? I don't remember him ever mentioning Junko before. I was always the one looking at it and going, hey, that looks like Junko's fingernails and all that, and Junko this, and I think it's Junko, and Junko, and Junko, and Junko, and Junko. I don't remember Monokuma saying check on Junko. Okay, it's not that, it's not that, it's not that, it's not that, confirm, it's not that. It could be, so the only choices now are present, photo, handbook, locker, locker. Or count. Okay,
shoot.
It's definitely not that. Four more chances. Four more bloody chances. I already did this, right? Yeah.
Shoot!
I can't remember if I did that one already. Damn it. No, 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 no. Possibility, 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 possibility. No, 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 no. I doubt it has anything to do with that. Okay. So it's either the photo, maybe the handbook.
Shoot!
Photo.
Shoot.
It's not that. It's not that. Nope. Nope. Did I try that one yet? I know I did the photo and I did the handbook. Locker. Locker. Go for it. Okay.
Shoot.
Still not that either. Well, the good news is there are only
I refuse to give up yet.
There are only like four. Well, only three or four left. Three or four choices that it has to be. Why does that have anything to do with the locker? The locker had to do with the handbook. So you think if it had anything to do with it, it would have to do with the handbook. I just... It's just... It doesn't make sense. How am I supposed to make a logical leap? It's not that. It's not that. Nope. 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 So right now we have locker, locker. DVD. DVD?
I got it!
The DVD?
While I was in the AV room, watching the DVD of our interviews with the headmaster.
Oh, that's why he interrupted. Because it would have shown the real Junko. Stupid. Or the real Mukuro. Either way. Yeah, okay. Stupid. Of course. Yeah. Forgot about that. Yeah. All of a sudden, oh yeah, it broke. He wants me to see something. Of course.
You made sure I couldn't finish watching the video. It's because you didn't want me to see the real
Junko. Oh yeah! If everyone was in that video, of course Junko would have had to show up.
And if Makoto saw the real Junko, it would have been totally obvious that the Junko we met was an imposter.
But that whole power outage thing was just a fluke!
Mastermind tried to cover up one other piece of evidence. Which is what? Oh, hell. Not again. Now it's gonna be the tough one. Well, still the easy one.
What do you want? What?
Oh,
what
do you want?
Are you sure about this? You're getting all riled up! That's impossible!
There we go.
That's impossible!
Photo. Interview. Oh no, that's stupid. Damn it. Ugh. I don't even know what all the choices are.
What?
Couldn't
what
pay
do
attention.
You want?
Okay, so.
That's impossible!
The photo, group photo. The group photo, yeah.
This should prove it.
That's why her face was always hidden.
The video wasn't the only thing you tried to cover up.
The same
you did the
photo.
Same thing
yeah.
with this group photo. I noticed it just a little while ago. When we were all comparing the photos we'd gotten, in all the photos, there's a certain similarity, an unusual circumstance.
What's so unusual about them?
Yep. Come on, let me. Oh, you're gonna show me. Yep. You can't see Junko's face. Turned around, blocked. Yep.
I got it!
I see Junko's face.
Junko's face.
Ah, I should have figured that out. I pointed that out in the first time I saw the picture. It's like, why is her face covered? That seems suspicious. And her tie. Her tie has the red
The one
red
thing
and
common
white.
To every single photo is that you can't see her face.
Mm-hmm. The red and white and the little stripe thing that Monokuma has. Yup. See, right there. The tie. Black and white.
It's hard to
like
believe
Monokuma.
Her face would just happen to be hidden in every single picture, don't you think? And on top of that, in this photo, you can see that Mukuro
is
clearly
visible.
So in other words, at that point, the two
of them
hadn't
switched.
With all that in mind, there's no doubt that the girl whose face is hidden here is the real Junko, which is why you had to have pictures that didn't show her face. Because if we could have seen her face, then it would have clearly revealed that the Junko in the
pictures
wasn't the Junko that we knew.
Xanadu!
I believe everything Makoto said is true. Junko and Mukuro switched places before we met either of them.
So she killed Mukuro, who had taken her place, making it look like she died. And the real Junko is still alive.
And she's the one behind this whole murderous situation. This killing game. She's the true mastermind and the ultimate despair.
Yeah, you tell her. You tell her, Makoto.
Xanadu times two!
With this, the identity and the crimes of the mastermind have been exposed.
Mm-hmm.
No! Wait! Hold on!
Don't bother trying to deny it.
Mm-hmm.
There's no more room for debate. You don't have anywhere left to run. I'll prove everything. Right now!
Oh, crap. Here we go. It's Junko meeting us. So who could that be? That's what everybody's meeting. I'm not sure what to put there, so let's go over here. Act 2. Yeah. Took the body. Someone is gonna kill. Something along those lines. Oh no, that's Koda right there. Okay. Wait. No, it's not that. So, okay, then here. That. Oh, that's right, they messed with the body. Oh, that's what is the first one. Because then they switch places. Okay. That's right, that was them messing with the body, so... body. Yeah, there's the bomb. No, there's gotta be something about moving the body, though. Placing the body and putting the mask on it. Right? Well, I think some of that's right anyway.
Well, the killer is you!
See if I got it right.
We met the ultimate fashionista, Junko and Oshima, right after we all arrived here. But that wasn't the real Junko.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
The girl we saw before us was actually the 16th student who had taken Junko's place. And that girl's name was Mukuro Ikusaba.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
But it wasn't long before she died at the hands of Monokuma. In other words,
the mastermind
Junko and Oshima.
Yep. And this one I'm not sure. Yeah, that's wrong. Okay, go back. Taking the body. Maybe that's where the cart came in. Wrapped up the body. Okay, that's where the cart comes in. Yeah. Okay. And that means the last one. It's putting the body. No, that's pulling the body out, though. Okay. Dead. Pulled out the body. That's what that is. Then what happens here? Is that? Oh, stupid. Yeah, that's right. She's pulling off the mask to see who it is. So. Then that's when he goes to Bluey. So what goes here then? Setting up the scene. Okay. And what does it end with? Maybe it ends with this. Because the bomb went off and they're all looking at the body. Okay. We're setting it up. We're all around the body.
Here's exactly what happened!
There we go.
Her body was kept in a biolab, which had been converted into a morgue until Junko decided to put her body to use.
Mm-hmm.
Junko dragged the body out of the biolab, using the tarp to carry her to the garden. Mm-hmm. She fabricated the murder to try and frame Kyoko, who'd proven to be one big thorn in her side.
Yep.
Meanwhile, she wanted us all to think Mukuro was still alive.
Yep.
And hiding somewhere inside the school.
Yeah, got it right.
So she put on a mask and then attacked
me.
After making sure I'd gotten a good look at the mask, she left the room.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Then she put the same mask on Mukuro's body. This was all to make us think the person who attacked me and the corpse
were the same. Well,
she wanted us to believe the murder had only recently taken place.
Yeah. And boom.
Finally, by strapping a bomb to the body, she was able to destroy any remaining evidence.
Mm-hmm.
She needed to hide the body's true identity. She had to make sure we didn't find out it was actually the same person we'd met in the beginning. This is the truth behind Mukuro's murder, and the one who carried it all out is the true mastermind. The one controlling Monokuma. The real Junko and Oshima!
Yep. Gotcha.
That's the whole story behind this incident. Well, what do you have to say to that?
What? Are you broken again?
You can't get out of this, so don't even try.
Come on! It's time you finally revealed yourself!
Yeah, here she comes.
It's not like you're an endangered species or something! How long do you plan to keep hiding?
Give it up, Junko. The game's over.
Over? Did you really think the story would end once we reached the climax of the case?
Well, yeah. I was kind of hoping that.
Wrong! There's still plenty more to go!
How so? Monoshima, ultimate despair, yeah.
We have been waiting! Waiting so very long for peasants like you to appear!
Okay.
If you swear your fealty to us, we will reward you with half of the entire world! We've even drawn up the deed already! We will grant you honor, status, in some of our home cooking! Have you made your choice? Will you serve under us?
No thanks.
Oh, did you think I was being serious? Sorry, I was just messing with you. It's been so long since I've had an audience. Even I'm not sure what kind of role I'm supposed to play.
Yeah, a little surprising.
Anyway, looks like I've finally been set free. Having to play Monokuma all the time, day after day, it was like I was stuck in purgatory, or like a slow suicide. I get bored so easy, you know?
Your face!
Huh? What about my face? What's wrong with my beautiful face? People have told me I'm cuter than 100 chihuahuas combined.
I feel like this isn't the first time I've seen you.
Sir. Well, before arriving at school? Oh, I think it was the first day. Never mind.
Shoot!
Oh, at least I still have health. Headmaster's room. Oh, before arriving at school. Yeah, that's right. When he was
that's
up
right.
Online and all that.
It was before I ever came to this school.
I remember seeing a magazine cover.
Seeing a magazine cover. And you were on it!
Yeah. She did look a lot different.
Wow, you have a pretty good memory. I guess that's why you've made it this far, huh?
So I was right. Then what you told me in the main hall when this all began...
Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
Sometimes a little lie is necessary to keep things moving along. Wouldn't you agree?
That explains why she didn't quite seem the same.
Mm-hmm.
Because she was a different person all along.
Exactly.
I'm me. And Mukuro is Mukuro. She tried her best. But there's just no way she could have passed as the ultimate fashionista. Two people can never become one as long as the walls of mind and body exist. Not even if they're twins.
Twins!
I know, it's such a cliche, right? I'm almost embarrassed to admit it. So basically,
okay.
Mukuro and I had your stereotypical twin relationship. The older sister, tough and proud. That was Mukuro. The younger sister, smart and cute.
Me!
Junko fucking Anashima! And together, we were the Despair Sisters, aka the Ultimate Despair!
How many personalities do you have?
Whoa! She's a totally different person now!
Like I said, I get bored easy as hell! I even get fucking bored with myself!
But if you're twins, why do you have different last names?
Oh, that again? You have any idea how many times people ask me that shit? Maybe it's new to your dumb ass, but it bores me to tears. Answering the same questions over and over? Just make up whatever answer you want. I don't give a shit. The truth's fucking lame anyway.
But if she was your twin, that means you killed your own sister?
You got bored.
And for reasons deeper and darker than the ocean. Ha! As if!
Well, I suppose I'd better explain. For my plan to work, someone had to be able to control the killing game from behind the scenes. The so-called mastermind had to operate Monokuma, keep an eye on everyone, things like that. But after looking at the situation, I determined it would be impossible for Mukuro to perform such duties. Because naturally, she turned out to be the letdown of the family, leaving me behind to run off and join some band of mercenaries. Such a disappointment. So, I decided to play the role of director and have her join the rest of you in your school life. I could have let her work alongside me, but she would have been useless to me that way. Besides, 15 students seemed like a solid number to start with. Of course, the fact that she was the ultimate soldier posed something of a problem. She had what I call the three atrocities: atrociously rank, atrociously filthy, atrociously repulsive. It was atrociously clear just how out of touch she was with the rest of society. Meanwhile, my ultimate fashionista status has an undeniable appeal that I didn't want to go to waste.
And that's why you switched identities?
Sadly, her inability to match my personality was even greater than I'd calculated. It was a lost cause. She was nothing more than a bit player, an extra, unworthy of lines. Being the utter disappointment that she was, anyone would have expected her to get killed off right away. Which is precisely why I killed her. To meet everyone's expectations.
Yeah. As soon as I met her, I figured, yeah, she'd probably be the first to go. And she was.
Can't be your only reason, can it?
Well, no, of course not. I also did it to avoid becoming bored.
Yep, I've never been a stickler for following a plan to the letter, you know? If I planned everything out and knew just what was gonna happen, that'd be so boring. So, I changed things just a bit and decided to use Mukuro to make a little point.
In other words, Mukuro's death was a one-sided, premeditated act of betrayal.
Yep.
Just as I suspected. When Mukuro was killed, she must have been as surprised as anybody else.
Yep. Yeah.
So you figured it out? Well, you're right! There's no way Mukuro could have pulled off such a convincing performance. But she did teach you all a very valuable lesson, don't you think?
How can you talk like that? You sacrificed your own sister! How does that not even bother you?
What? I sacrificed her? That's what's got you so hot under the collar? Jeez, misunderstandings sure are scary. We were the ultimate despair, you know? So we never had any kind of hope or expectations. Nope, I felt despair as long as I can remember. Like I never should have been born at all. When I was born, I cried tears of total despair. So that's why for us, it's not a big deal whether we die or kill. We're just those kinds of people. We can do anything! We've always been filled with despair. So when we do something, we go all the way and live without regret.
So you just murdered your own sister and didn't think anything of it?
Yeah.
That's not true at all.
You were twins.
How could I not be sad? That's why it gets me so excited. Killing my precious sister with my own two hands. That act is filled with so much despair. You can't help but put a super in front of it. It's like super, 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 super despair. No, More than that. Super, 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 super despair. It just feels so good.
What the hell is wrong with you?
And my sister, too. In that moment of death, I think she must have felt that despair. After all, to be murdered by your own sister, and only as an example to someone else. She must have died feeling such excruciating hopelessness. I'm so jealous of her. Super jealous.
I knew you couldn't be just some ordinary person. You're some kind of abnormality.
Turning your own despair into some kind of fetish. Abnormality doesn't even begin to describe it.
Like, Genocide Jill is crazy for sure, but this is a whole nother level of nuts!
You're saying I don't compare to some lowly beast that can only kill the weak, right? So, I'm hopelessly attractive, hopelessly brilliant, hopelessly athletic. I'm the hopelessly perfect ultimate human.
No, I don't think there's anything perfect about anything you just said.
Yeah, Master's way more perfect, because on top of everything else, he's got that noble blood.
Don't you mean had that noble blood?
What did you just say? What do you mean by that?
You still haven't figured that part out yet? Man, you guys are so slow! You haven't even solved all the mysteries, and yet here you are, yap, yap, yapping away!
Are you talking about our memories?
You've already solved this mystery, right? I'm the killer! So how about the next one? Maybe you should solve the riddle of your missing memories! Then you can start gloating!
Damn straight! That's exactly what we're going to do! We're going to solve all these mysteries! And then, we'll have our victory!
Okay.
I can't wait!
Please let me save.
Alright, then let's just get straight to the point! What memories did you steal from us?
When the group pictures were taken, and those interviews, it must mean... I got it! It must have something to do with our entrance exams!
No fair! At least give us a hint!
Your brains are like sponges, all drippy and leaky! I already gave you a hint before! All the memories you lost share something in common with a few other things! Do you recall?
Memories that were stolen from us and what they must be related to. The motives?
I got it!
Yeah.
You're talking about the motives you provided to try and get us to kill each other, right?
So you do remember after all. Well, I would hope you wouldn't forget something so important. It was stupid of me to even ask. I apologize from the bottom of my heart for my bad manners. So then, let me ask you another question. Did you notice that each motive I presented you had a specific theme to it?
Specific theme?
A theme?
Yep, you got it. So that's my question to you all. When Sayaka was murdered, what was the theme of the motive I presented?
Monokuma gave us those DVDs. When on my DVDs, footage of my family was her and her friends. They had a dream they all shared, so the first murder was we were. So the first murder, the motive we were given was.
I got it! The driving force behind the motive you presented us with at that point was human connections.
Yeah.
Ding, ding, ding. You got it. Remember those DVDs I gave you guys? Each video showed the total destruction of your most important relationships. For example, your family. For example,
your friends.
I ruined all those relationships and showed you the results. It was to motivate your desire to escape and kickstart your urge to kill. But still, what a cruel thing to do.
You're the one that did it!
Yes, well, I'm perfectly happy to accept your disapproval.
Okay! Time for the next question! So, what was the theme for the second motive?
Second merge. What was the second? Weird envelopes from Monokuma. Mine mentioned how I used it. Okay. So, the meaning of that past. The past.
I got it!
Yeah.
It was our past, right?
Yay! Makoto got it right again! That time, the theme was... embarrassing memories and secrets! Yeah. And the whole reason Mondo did what he did was to protect his secret.
So, how long do you plan on dragging this out?
Relax, relax. Okay, on to the next question. So, what was the motive for the third murder?
That's right, Celeste. She wanted to buy a European castle and live there with a bunch of handsome men, so I signed them. Popularity? Or greed? No. Yeah. No, no, no. It's greed. It's greed. Screw
Shoot.
Up. It's greed. It's greed. Come on. Greed.
I got it! It was money, wasn't it? Greed.
Greed.
Seek and destroy! Hell yeah, you got it again!
Yep.
Goddamn straight it was money! Celeste killed Hifumi and Taka for a little personal gain! Her greed led to all kinds of death and destruction!
What's the point of all this? Why are you making us go through this case by case?
Don't worry, sweet cheeks. Just one more to go. Now, can you tell me the motive behind crazy-ass Sakura's crazy-ass death?
Blackmail? No.
Shoot!
Okay, still got health, good. That's what it was, but... Let me see secrets. What? She hit something.
Shoot!
What she hit? Oh, because she betrayed us. Because of her betrayal? She killed herself? Past. Betrayal.
I got it!
It's the only other one.
In her case, it was betrayal.
Precisely. You see, once I revealed Sakura's betrayal, that led to everything that came afterwards.
That's right.
Anyway, it looks like you answered all of my questions correctly. How painfully delightful.
But what's the point? What meaning is there in asking those questions now?
Relationships? Secrets? Money? Betrayal? These are all pretty standard motives, right? The most normal of normal. Totally middle of the road.
But of course, those aren't the only motives that exist in this world. In fact, there are as many reasons to kill as there are people on Earth. They compel humans to kill each other, bringing despair to the world. This is what we refer to as the Seed of Despair.
Seed of Despair?
Just as water, air, and food promote growth in living things, the Seed of Despair also needs nourishment. And that nourishment is hope. Despair can grow only in the presence of hope. Two sides of the same coin, divided by a razor-thin line. Such is hope and despair.
How much longer is this stupid speech of yours? Weren't we discussing our missing memories? Why are you trying to change the subject?
If you would listen, you would see I'm not changing the subject. We are discussing your memories. What I'm trying to say is, the seed of despair is closely tied to your own...
How so?
You see, by taking away your memories, I gave you hope. Of course, that hope merely existed to be consumed by despair.